Hello there. Today we'll discuss the scenario of how shifting of weight on a ship will affect its stability. Now, ships for their operational purpose would require that sometimes some weight has to be transferred from one place of the ship to the other, either during the journey or in a port when loading unloading happens. Now, during the voyage, the ship may have to change its trim or change its heel or remove its heel or list. So, in all these scenarios, you may have to shift some mass like ballast water, etc. from one place, from one tank to the other. So when such an action is taken, that will have an impact on the stability of the vessel, which can be theoretically calculated by studying how the center of gravity of the ship will change. So that is what we are trying to study or explore in this video. Now consider the vessel which has some weights, each of W kept at the top at the deck here as shown in the figure. So initially the center of gravity of this entire system, that is the ship plus all these weights, is assumed to be at a point G, and K is definitely the keel of the vessel. Now imagine that a weight W is removed from one particular position of the vessel as shown here. Then the center of gravity now will shift to a new point G1. How can we locate this point G1? For that, let us imagine that the weight which has been removed from this position has been added at some new position here. Okay, for some operational purpose, a weight W has been lifted from this place and kept here, placed over here. So now the center of gravity will shift from G1 to G2. Okay, so how do we find G1? How do we find G2? G2 is more important because that is the final position of center of gravity. Now listen carefully. The line GG2, okay, the line which is connecting G, which is the initial center of gravity, and G2, which is the final center of gravity, this line will be parallel to WW line. WW line is the W, the position of the weight initially, and this W is the position of the weight in the final situation. So if I draw a line like this, which is called as a WW line, so your GG2 line will be parallel to the WW line. So that is one method by which we can locate the final position G2 of the center of gravity of a ship when we have shifted a weight. And the distance GG2 we can calculate by the formula W into D by W, where D is the distance between W to W. So this is a formula to find out, to calculate the shift in center of gravity when a weight W has been shifted by a distance D on a ship, and the shift in center of gravity will be across a line which is parallel to how the weight has been shifted on board the vessel. Now, practically, if we can consider the scenario in bulk carriers, which carry bulk cargo in solid form in cargo holds, we can see here in this figure as shown, the capital letter G will represents the original position of ship's center of gravity when the ship is upright, and AB represents the level of surface of grain when ship was upright. So when the ship was upright without any heel list condition, AB was the level of surface of grain. Now CD represents the level when the ship is inclined. Okay, so a wedge of grain AOC, AOC with its center of gravity at G has shifted to ODB. This is a wedge. Wedge is nothing but a triangular shape, three-dimensional object. A wedge AOC with CG at G has shifted to ODB with CG at G1. So the new center of gravity of the ship G1 will be such that GG1 is parallel to the small GG1. This is how we can locate the new center of gravity of the ship because of shifting of bulk cargo inside the hold when the ship has healed. Now let us quickly discuss a numerical. A ship has a displacement of 2400 tons and kg 10.8 meters. Find the new kg if a weight of 50 ton mass already on board is raised 12 meters vertically. Now before we start this question, let us be very clear that there has been no addition or removal of mass in this question, in this scenario. There is only a shifting of mass from one place to the another. So the shift as given in the question is 12 meters vertically and the displacement of the vessel is given 2400 tons. The shift of mass is of 50 tons. So as per the formula, if you can simply apply the formula is W into D pi capital W. So 0.25 meters will be the shift in center of gravity vertically. Now let us discuss the scenario of suspended weight. Suppose a crane on board a ship lifts a mass W. You can see here in this case a weight W has been lifted by a derrick. So now the situation can also be considered that the weight W, instead of being at this point, we can imagine, I'll repeat, we can imagine that this W is placed at this point, which is equivalent to shifting of weight from bottom, from this position to A. So G also will move to G1 parallel to WA. Now just imagine how dangerous the scenario has become, because you have simply lifted a mass to a few distance from its base, but in effect you can see depending on the dimension of the crane, in effect the shifting of mass has increased to this much distance depending on the dimension of the crane. So that is why having a crane on board a ship and lifting of a mass on board a ship is a highly dangerous scenario. Again we can simply use the formula GG1 is W into D by W. This will be the formula which can be used to find out effect of suspended weight on center of gravity. I hope this video has helped you to understand the theory behind the shifting of mass and suspended weight scenario. In case of any doubts, please do email me at my email ID pramod.imu@gmail.com. Thank you for listening.